So hey guys, my name is Ishwar Saimarty Prasad and you are watching Fact Side Dip channel. And there is a flash news that India thwarts the fresh Chinese attempt to alter the status quo in the Ladakh. Beijing is still in denial. There is a flash news that the Chinese troops tried to enter the Indian border illegally. So let's analyze that situation. India foiled an attempt by Chinese troops to change the status quo on their disputed border. The line of actual control lay in a fresh flare up between the nuclear armed nations. But China refused the India statements, claiming its troops never crossed the line of actual control. Army spokesperson Colonel Aman Anand on Monday said that troops from China's People's Liberation Army PLA violated the previous consensus and arrived during the military and diplomatic engagements on the ongoing standoff in the eastern Ladakh and carried out provocative military movements to change the status quo on the night of August 29th. On the night of August 29th to August 30th, 2020, PLA troops violated the previous consensus and arrived at the military and the diplomatic engagements. Said Indian soldiers foiled the Chinese bit to unliterally change facts on the ground. For months, troops have been locked in a face-off in the western Himalayas, where both sides accuse the other of violating the line of actual control or the de facto border. The Indian Army said that the latest flare-up took place along the high altitude of the Pangong So Lake, which is the southern side of the Pangong So Lake. Indian troops got the notice of this PLA activity in the southern bank of the Pangong So Lake and undertook measures to strengthen our positions and thwart the Chinese intentions to unilaterally change facts on the ground, it said. To this end, the Chinese foreign minister said the Chinese border troops never crossed the line of actual control, adding both sides are in communication regarding the situation on the ground. It is the first major incident involving the troops of two countries after the Galwan Valley clashes on June 15, in which 20 Indian Army personnel were killed. China also suffered casualties, but it is yet to make details to the public. But according to an American intelligence report, it was 35. India and China have held several rounds of military and diplomatic talks in the last 2.5 months, but no significant headway has been made for a resolution to the border row in the eastern Ladakh. The two sides began a process of disengagement on July 6th, a day after the telephonic conversation between National Security Advisor Ajit Doval and Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi on ways to bring down the tensions in the eastern Ladakh. However, the process has not moved forward since mid-July. PLA has pulled back from the Galwan Valley and certain other friction areas, but the withdrawal of the troops has not moved forward in the Pangong So and the Depsang and a couple of other areas. At the 5 rounds of the COPS commander level talks, the Indian side has been insisting on complete disengagement of Chinese troops at earliest and immediate restoration of status quo ante in all the areas of eastern Ladakh prior to the April. The face-off began on May 5th following violent clashes between two armies in the Pangong So Lake area. The incident in the Pangong So was followed by similar incident in the North Sikkim on May 9th. The India-China border dispute covers the 3,488-kilometer line of actual control LAC. Prior to the clashes, both the sides have been asserting that pending the final resolution of the boundary issue, it is necessary to maintain peace and tranquility in the border areas. Even both sides were engaged in the diplomatic and military talks. The Indian Army stepped up its strength in all key areas along the LAC to deal with eventualities. The Chief of Army Staff, General M.M. Naravane has already conveyed to all the senior commanders of the army overseeing the operation of the frontline formations along the LAC to keep up a significantly high state of alertness and maintain the aggressive posturing to deal with any Chinese misadventure, sources said. The tension between the two sides escalated manifold after the Galwan Valley clashes, as we all know. Following the incident, the government gave the armed forces full freedom to give an unbeatable response to any Chinese misadventure along the LAC. The army sent thousands of the additional troops to forward locations along the border following the deadly clashes. The IAF Indian Air Force has also moved air defense systems as well as sizable number of frontline combat jets and attack helicopters to several key air bases.